Hey everybody, welcome back to the Mac Whisperer Academy. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer. And if you're one of the many people that is completely overwhelmed by your email, then this lesson was made just for you. Email is a critical and essential part of our communication infrastructure. It's also really annoying, really frustrating, and almost impossible to get a handle on, which is why I've decided to make a series of videos to help you get more organized with MacMail. This is part one, the basics. I'm going to give you a walkthrough of the entire application, and if you stick with me until the end of this episode, I'm going to tell you my number one best tip on how to use MacMail. It's a tip that will allow you to find any email you're looking for anytime and anywhere without having to search for it. So that's enough of me yammering. Let's hop over to the computer and let's get into MacMail. I'm going to come down to my dock right here and click on it. When it first opens up, I want you to look at the left side. The left side is called the sidebar. It's broken down into separate sections. At the top, we've got our favorites section. And as we scroll down a little bit, we've got smart mailboxes, which we'll cover in a future episode. And each of the accounts that you've got configured in your mail program will show up here. They show up with their own inbox and their own sent folder and their own trash and any folders that you've got. And they take up a ton of space. We're going to start off by talking about how scrolling is the enemy of productivity. You see, the more you have to go up and down and up to find what you're looking for, the more annoying it gets and the less you get done. The favorites section is made to be customized so that everything you need can be shown in that section, so you don't have to scroll around for it all the time. So the first thing we need to do is close some of these sections off and begin to customize our favorites section. So let's start at the bottom here. I'm going to turn off my iCloud account here. I'm going to turn off my MacWhisperer account here. And when I say turn it off, I'm not actually deactivating it. I'm just compressing or condensing this account file so I don't have to look at it all the time. I'll go ahead and compact my IT with IQ account. And now I'm going to close some of these icons. When you're looking at your favorites section, on the left side, you'll see this little arrow that allows you to drop down every section. The problem is, most people leave them open and then it's overwhelming. So I'm going to close my flags and my drafts and my sent and my junk and my trash. I'm going to leave my all inboxes open and we'll talk about why in just a moment. Let's discuss how you add things to the favorites section. It's pretty easy. You move your cursor over to favorites and over to the right, you'll see that little plus button show up. Click on the plus button and then you can hit this drop down menu and pick any folder you want to have it show up as part of your favorites. In this case, I'm going to go into my IT with IQ account and choose the personal folder, which I use pretty frequently. Now I'm going to click OK. And you're going to notice that that folder shows up on the left side at the bottom of favorites. But let's say you decide you don't want that folder or there's something else on favorites that you don't need. No problem. I'm going to right click on my personal folder and I'm going to choose remove from favorites because I don't really need it there. If you have your account here, you can actually right click on a folder here and add it to the favorites that way also. I'm going to now go ahead and close that down. You can reorganize the favorites section by grabbing anything and just moving it to a different location. If you want it up higher, you want it up at the top, or you want it down below, and then you let it go and it's going to move into that different location. I suggest you have your all inboxes, all drafts, all sent, all junk, and all trash. This will make it easier for you to not have to go down to those lower accounts to find things. When you click at the top of one of these sections, it will show you all of the accounts underneath it. So by having it open here, I can go into separate accounts and check out their inboxes easily. For the other things, I tend to leave them closed. You can certainly open things up and move things around however you want to. It's your favorite section. It's your sidebar. But that's the way I like to have it set up. And with that being said, we're going to move over and we're going to talk about the toolbar. The toolbar is this bar across the top of your window with all these little icons on it. Some people have it where you can't see the words beneath the icon. It's easy to change by right-clicking on the header and choosing icon and text. You can also click customize toolbar to make changes to the toolbar, which can allow you to add something in or remove something you're not using. Now I want to talk about a couple of the parts of the toolbar. Some of them are just really obvious. We don't need to get into them a lot. Here's new message, that creates a new message. And here's get mail, that checks for your messages, but your email checks every 5 minutes anyway, so I don't really think you need that very often. Here's the delete button, but there's easier ways to delete, and you can reply and reply all and forward and junk. Here's the button that you can use to sort something into a specific folder. And here's the button you use to search. The only one I want to spend time on right now is this button right here, which is called the filter button. Now I want you to look at your sidebar again. You see all those numbers that show up to the right of the separate accounts? That is the unread emails in that account. And this filter button here makes it easy to see your unread messages. If you click this filter, it can do a lot of things, and we'll talk about some of them later, but the default setting is to show you just your unread messages. So go ahead and play around with it and turn it on and check out how it does things and how it shows you just the unread messages. But be really careful. A lot of my clients have a nasty tendency of leaving this on and then they miss emails because they already read them, but they didn't deal with them yet. So don't leave it on, but it's a helpful thing to be able to come in and just filter things by just what's been read. That's the basics of the toolbar. We'll talk more about a few of those tools later on. Message view is this column right here where you see all of the emails with their previews. Whenever you're in any folder, it's going to show you all of the messages inside that folder. And it's going to give you a little preview. It shows you some good information. Up at the top, it tells you who it's from, and then it shows you the subject, it tells you when it was sent, and two lines for the preview. When you're looking at the message window, you might also see flags that'll show up here, or attachments that'll show up here. You can sort the message view easily by coming up to the view menu here and going to sort by, and you can change it from date or from or size, or you can put all your unreads in one place or have all your attachments gathered together. There's lots of ways to sort it. I tend to leave it on date with the newest on the top because it's just the easiest way for me to keep on top of things. You may need to mark things as unread. It happens a lot until someone has a good system that in order to keep track of an email, they go, oh my God, I'm gonna forget that if I don't have it marked as unread. It's easy to mark something as unread by right-clicking on it and choosing mark as unread. But there's an easier way to do it too, and that requires a mouse or a trackpad. What you're going to do is you're gonna swipe from the left side to the right side, and you're gonna see you get two options, unread or remind me. If you swipe from the right to the left, you're going to get the option to delete. And if you do a partial swipe like this, then you have to click on one of these two buttons. But if you do a full swipe, it will automatically mark it as unread, just like that. You don't have to stop and take a separate step. And if you want to delete something, do it the opposite direction, but a full swipe, a half swipe is going to make you click on that. A full swipe is going to allow you to just get rid of it. If you need to move something into a folder, it's really easy to do by just clicking on it and dragging it into whatever folder you need to move it to. But I like to move things by right-clicking on them. So if you right-click on it here, you can come down to where it says move to, and you'll notice that all your accounts are right there, so you can put something in any one of those folders, and all of your favorites are up at the top. It makes it really easy to file things, especially if you can't see the folder you're putting it in because it's closed off or because there's too much there and you would have to scroll for it. Last thing about the message view, a lot of people are in the habit of double-clicking on everything, which is just not that necessary anymore. If you double-click on something in the message view, it's going to open up a separate window. Which is fine, except then you gotta deal with that separate window. And if you open a bunch of things, you're gonna have 15 or 20 windows, they're gonna be floating around, you're gonna have to minimize them, they're gonna be in the way. And when you single click on it, in the detail view on the right, you see the entire message, but you don't have to close the window because you didn't open a window. That's what I've got for the message view. Now let's talk about the detail view. The detail view is the far right column here. Whenever you click on a message, it shows the entire message right there, and you can scroll up and down on it and find whatever you need to within that message. In addition to that, when you're up at the top, you're going to notice that it shows the name of who sent it. If you click the arrow to the right, it will give you the actual email address and also give you an option to add that person to your contacts if you need to. This is a very helpful thing to do so that your address book is organized and has all the people you're communicating with. Down below that, we see the subject line. Over to the right, we see what folder it's in and the date and time. We also see attachments and flags. When you have a message that has an attachment, this one has one down at the bottom here, it can be hard to find and hard to see those attachments and really hard to deal with and save them. The easy way to do that is to hover over this bar at the top, and this little window will pop up giving you the ability to delete, reply, reply all, or forward, which I never use because I use right click and other tools to do that, but it also gives you the ability to see your attachments. Clicking on the little paperclip will allow you to save all of the attachments, in this case there's just one, or select any of the attachments and save that one attachment individually. When you click on an attachment, it will open up your save dialog box and ask you where you want to put it. Easy, simple. But there's one other thing you can do with that attachment button. If you click on it and go to the quick look section, it will zoom into that attachment so you can see what that attachment has in it without having to go through all the hoopla of opening another program to see it. You can get out of Quick Look by pressing your space bar on your keyboard or by clicking the little X in the upper left-hand corner here. One last thing about the detail view. In some cases, you may see something that alerts you that this is from a mailing list. I can click this button to get myself off the mailing list. So that's one of the other tools of the detail view. Now, let's talk about the new message window. Creating a new message is easy. You can go right up to the top at your toolbar here and click it, or you can use one of my favorite key codes, Command plus N, just like that. When you go into the To section and you want to address it, if you start typing a couple of letters, it will look in your address book to find any people or any groups, and it will also look into the memory of the mail program in case you've emailed this person before. When you find the one you want to email, all you do is highlight it with your mouse and click on it, or while you're typing it, you can go ahead and press the return key on your keyboard or the comma. The comma will allow you to immediately add another person and another person very easily so that you can address it to multiple people without having to come back and forth between the keyboard and the mouse. Now, when you want to go from the To section to the other sections, you can either use your mouse to just move down, or you can press the Tab key on your keyboard, which will take you from the To section to the CC section to the subject line. Never ever send an email without a subject line because it's just going to end up in somebody's spam filter by mistake. If it's part of a conversation, make sure it's relevant to the conversation because that's really helpful. Underneath the subject line is the From section. Clicking on here will allow you to choose from any email address that you've got configured on your mail program so you can send from wherever you want to. There's also a tool called Hide My Email, but we'll talk about that in a future video. To the right, we've got our signatures. If you've created signatures, they'll show up here and you can change them by just flipping things around. Let's come down to the body here and let's type in a quick message. Once you've finished typing your message, you're ready to send it. And you can do that by clicking the little paper airplane up at the top. But over to the right of that is a little arrow that allows you to schedule this email to be sent later. Over to the right over here, we've got our attach button. Clicking it opens up your finder and allows you to grab anything you want so that you can easily add it to your email, just like that. But I don't commonly use the attach button. I find there's easier ways to do it by dragging and dropping things right into your email message. So I'm going to open up my finder here and grab the attachment that I want and just drag it right in. And it shows up right there without my having to hit the attach button. Over to the right of the attach button is this text format button, and this is really, really helpful. When you click this, it brings down a whole other layer of tools that will allow you to take any part of your message and change the size and the font and the color and make it personal and make it look like whatever you want it to look like. Over here, we've got our emojis button. Clicking on that will allow you to bring up your emoji screen. Don't forget, you can always search to find a specific emoji that you're looking for. You can then click on it or drag it to where you want it to be, and that's the emojis. And over to the right is a really helpful piece called the photo browser. If you've got another Apple product like your phone or your iPad nearby, you can use it to take a photo, scan a document, or add a sketch directly into your email. But if you don't and you just want to grab a photo from your photo library, clicking up here will open up your photo library. and allow you to select any image or images that you've got and just drag them right into your email so they show up and they're right there front and center. Be aware that on the right side, when you add images, you'll see this little section called image size. This controls how large the message is and how large the images are. If you want really good quality, keep it on original image. See how much bigger that is? But look on the left side where it says message size, and you're gonna see that that size increases based on how big this particular image is. If you wanna send a lot of images, leave it small. I tend to leave things more or less in the middle, in the medium section. It's not that big, and it doesn't take up that much space. But it's really up to you how you want to set up and organize that. So that's the basics of how to get around on MacMail. It's an amazing program with a lot of tools, and we'll get into more of that as we move forward. But before I step into the bonus, take a moment. If you're getting value out of this video and you've learned something new, give me a thumbs up. And if you've got questions or suggestions, drop them right into the comments section. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, why not? Take a moment, hit that subscribe button and that notify bell so you're always alerted whenever I drop new content. Now, let's talk about that power tip. One of the overwhelming parts about email is keeping track of the messages you want. You might have seen it, you might have read it, you might have addressed it, but you may need to reference it later. You need a way to keep track of them. Leaving everything as unread is not the right way to do it, which is where the flags come in. So first off, on your sidebar, I'm going to open up my flags, and you're going to see that I've got a number of flags in a number of different colors. You have up to 7 colors that you can utilize for these flags, and you can give the flags all sorts of names. Go ahead and click on a message and right click on it, and you can choose any one of these colors. You might say to yourself, well, what should I use these colors for? Here are some of the suggestions that I use. You can create all sorts of different topics for these flags, but the key is when you have your messages and you're using these flags properly, rather than hunting around and searching and trying to save stuff or leaving windows open, which a lot of people do, you can easily right-click something to flag it or flag it from the toolbar up above, and now it's right where you're looking for it and it's easy for you to find it when it's time to look that up. And that's our lesson for today. I'm Dylan Stewart. They call me the Mac Whisperer, and it's my passion and profession to help you get more done with your Apple products than you ever thought possible. And I will see you next time.